start just low hand and raise the knee. We're going to work on a really simple movement, and what we're going to do is challenge different parts of your body throughout this movement. Everybody's going to do exactly the same thing. What we're going to look for is our standard above head streamline position. Hands are all the way down to the toes, keep the legs bent, or keep the legs straight. All the way up, all the way down. If you're on the power plate, you're turning around facing out. Everybody ready? 60 seconds. If you have a med ball, grab your med ball. If you have a kettlebell, grab your kettlebell. Oh, it'll be the same. Don't worry. 60 seconds. From the floor, jump above your head. 3, 2, 1, go. Do what they're doing. Look at that. Look at it. It's like one of the advanced groups right there. They all advance. All advance. Oh, it'll be okay. Yeah, just up and down. But in a couple seconds, I bet that the people in the front are going to go to the back, and everybody else is going to move to the front. Stretch! Woo! I'm going to get all confused. Get mad.
Excuse me.
3, 2, 1, and go!
I can barely stand. Hey, what are you?
So everybody's going to have different things that they're working on. They're going to all get exposed on one apparatus or another. That's the point. You're fine. Stay with it.
Wait, Laura, how are
you? Okay, so this is about as simple as the movement could possibly be. Gross motor school. We moved a lot of blood. We moved a lot of oxygen. So now we're going to move into an isometric hold. So now we're moving a lot of blood and a lot of oxygen. We're going to open up the low back, open up the legs, and open up our chest. Everybody's going to sit in a squat position. If you have the kettlebell, you're going to keep the elbows inside so they're centered directly underneath the wrists and keep them pushed out in the front over the knees. If you have the med ball, you can hold it any place you would like. Same thing, sit your butt down. If you're on the Bosu, sit your butt down. If you're on the power plate, sit your butt down. I would be a machine, you're probably going to fall apart. Well, you guys will probably have to hold on. You can hold on only if you have to.
Try
to make it without it. Everybody, stand there! 3, 2, 1, go! Hey, bird! It's not gonna kill you. It'll kill you by the third or fourth minute. Hold in there. Let him hurt! So by now, your heart rate's up. Your circulation's up. It's going like this. And now we opened up the thinking muscle group and we're letting the lactic acid just pour in. So they don't like the fact. Just enjoy. Get in there. Drop your butt low. Put your chin up. Be willing to almost fall back and fall on your butt. If you're willing to fall on your butt, you will not. If you're scared to fall on your butt, you might. Sit back. Chin down. Let it burst. You want to keep the head and chest high. 30 seconds or you just get in 15 swings and it will work. The hips move, shoulder stays over. And then 15 swings, other hand. You want to bounce it in front of you, keeping your thoracic cavity high. So the key is to drop my navel down into the well while keeping my face in position. You're on the Bosu. The hands are simply here. You're just going to hold. You don't have to do a thing. Just keep your shoulders directly above your elbows. Elbows directly above your wrists. If you're on the power plate, the elbows are down in a body plank position.
Nope.
At least it's not going to be on this.
Elbows are
down. Are we ready? 3, 2, 1, go! So you want to keep it at a right angle only. Don't hit yourself in the back of the head. Streamline. Right angle, streamline. The right angle means you're going to have to stop it. It won't stop on its own. It'll get down here. I don't want it down here. Streamline, streamline, streamline. If you're on the kettlebell. If you're on the ball, you're holding the ball at your chest. Your elbows are at shoulder height. As we exhale, the abdominals sit back and inside the cavity. The hands 10. You are on the Bosu. We're now gonna move these arms. So I got my shoulders directly above my elbows directly above my wrists. You got a couple choices. You can roll your core. You can keep your core steady and move your shoulders. Or you can move your elbows. Or you can move them all. Totally up to you. You have to go side to side. If you're on the power plate, hands are down. It's a simple Dady's test. So the hands are down. As we exhale, pull the navel up towards the spine. The core gets lifted. Here we go. Find the position. Three, two, one, go.
Oh my goodness. I'm 14, just straight up.
My shoulders are back. One, two, three. If you have the med ball, we're holding the med ball into your belly. We're doing exactly the opposite. The butt starts in the back. It's a jump. You're pulling yourself off the floor. You are not pushing. It's a pull. You're trying to pull the ball up into your belly. If you're on the Bosu, it's 30 seconds. You'll be able to see the clock. It's going to give you about 30 steps. We're lifting the belly up and through. After 30 seconds or 30 steps, switch feet. The pull is up through the navel and through the diaphragm. It's one exhale per pull. If you are on the power plate, we're simply coming forward through the core. You're bringing the knee to same side elbow. Empty the lungs, fill the lungs. This is the last one of these. It will be brutal. We'll make it. 3, 2, 1, 2. Everything you got left. Use your core. Yank everything through the middle. Force the exhale. You'll get hot. You'll get tired. You're loud. Be aggressive. Be aggressive. It's the last 4 minutes of work. Push. Turnover. Again and again. Come on. We got 35 seconds. Just nail it to the wall for 30 seconds. Go. Come on, switch feet on the step. Go, ladies. Go again. Come on. Jump. Yes, you're gonna get tired. It's all right. Be tired. It's almost over. Can you be tired for 18 seconds straight? Go. 12 seconds to go. It's a flip turn and go. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Don't get touched up. Time. Hey, that there, that's how you finish. Take a break. Nice work.